Welcome to a session on enhancing road safety by keeping a tab on poor vision. And today we have with us Vinod Daniel and Tristan Gross. Vinod Daniel, who is the Managing Trustee and CEO of India Vision Institute, which was established in 2012. And through its extensive activities and programs, including vision screenings across India's far corners, have helped IVI attain many achievements. IVI's vision is to augment the primary eye care capacity of India. IVI aims to provide a pair of spectacles to every Indian in need of one. For prevention of avoidable blindness, IVI works to provide timely intervention in disadvantaged communities and remote areas. Through its IC and iLearn and IC and iWork program, IVI is working across India to provide children and adults access to vision screening and free spectacles. To advance Indian optometry, IVI works to raise awareness, capacity building, leadership development, and promoting the research culture. Tristan Gross has served as Global Executive Director of the Vision Impact Institute since 2017. And in this role, she leads a global team of experts to create expanded awareness through evidence-based research and to advocate for the global need to prioritize vision care. Prior to taking this position, Tristan served as the Global Director of Content and Communications for the organization and successfully led traditional and social media expansion and advocacy initiatives in countries around the world. She is an expert storyteller in the global need for vision care and is dedicated to truly giving vision a voice. To begin with this session, I would like to ask the first question. How critical is vision when it comes to road safety? Vinodji, do you feel much emphasis has been given to it?
First of all, thank you very much, Madhur, for inviting me for this interaction. And it's great to see you, Kristen. Look, I mean, I think in India, there is an issue of uncorrected refractive error that's not being dealt with, you know, in the whole adult population overall. There are millions and millions of adults who can't, you know, work, do things productively, etc., because they can't see well. We recently did a large eye screening project with truck drivers. Out of about 10,000 drivers, nearly half of them needed some eye correction. But the difficult part we had to deal with is about 1.4%, which is about 140 out of the 10,000 drivers. Legally, they shouldn't actually be on the road, you know, with whatever criteria. I think the struggle would be for them to see a signal from a reasonable distance, to look at road signs, etc. Now, they themselves might not have known that the vision is that bad, but I think as a system, we need more things in place that would probably make sure that these people go, get their eyes checked, get a pair of glasses. Good, safe for them would also be safe for the average person on the road.
Kristen, is there any data available on the number or percentage of unsafe drivers, especially truck drivers on road with poor vision?
Yeah, thank you again for having me as well. I think the one thing that we have to look at is that it's difficult to have an exact number, so we can ballpark numbers very easily. When we look at the numbers of uncorrected drivers around the world, it's generally estimated at around 23% of drivers are driving uncorrected. Those numbers by the Boston Consulting Group are actually showing that India drivers are right around 42% driving uncorrected. So there's a big gap in the world view and then the India view. But when we look at the numbers of truck drivers, especially, this is a very large population of people. It's one of the reasons that we focus here. In 2019, it was estimated that there were about 20 million heavy truck drivers on the roads in India. So if we just do a back of the envelope kind of estimation of how many drivers might be driving uncorrected in that respect, we could say up to about our 8.4 million truck drivers on the road who could be driving without the correction that they need to be safe on the roads.
Wonderful, Vinodji. If you could also join us to discuss these statistics.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think the numbers Kristen has shared, I think, though, you know, it's large, but, you know, that's the reality. And I think the critical aspect is what can we do, you know, to make sure, you know, over the next decade, we can slowly look at addressing on steps that can be taken, you know, and if it's okay, Madhur, I can probably share a little bit on what, you know, Kristen, who represents Vision Impact Institute, you know, we from India Vision Institute, and you're also involved in that process, and, you know, Sightsavers and Vision Spring and others are doing, you know, in this realm. Now, it's a question of looking at it holistically in terms of how to address this issue. And that would involve not just getting, you know, policies and legislations in place, which I think would be great. But it's also to look at, you know, what the other issues are. Things like, you know, is there a stigma associated with drivers wearing glasses? And how do you change the perception both for the individual who's driving as well as others who might, you know, get in, whether, you know, this person is a truck driver or a cab driver, that look, the driver is safer with a pair of glasses. So what do you do about that particular stigma? Access is an issue in countries like India with the large shortage in human resources. So I think it's quite important. And going along with that also is a question on what additional measures could be put in place when it comes to driving license renewals, as well as other checks and balances that need to be put into the system. So I think looking at it comprehensively, and it's great there is a group that is now working on it. And eventually, I think the fruits of that would be seen in years to come, especially I think over the next decade, you'll see a marked change.
Great. And Vinod, one thing I would add to that is just when you say, what can we do? These are interventions that we can take. What I'd love to frame up is that, you know, a study that was done in 2016 shows that 81% or people who have at least one visual impairment have an 81% crash involvement rate. That sounds terribly high, but if you look at people with good vision, they have a 51% crash involvement rate. So what we can do is that gap, that 30% difference. If we can make a difference, taking into consideration all of the tactics and the measures that Vinod has just mentioned, to just take care of that 30%, we will have made a huge impact in India.
From a global perspective, how bad is the situation in India, Vinodji?
Look, I mean, I think probably the situation in India would be comparable to the situation in many developing countries, you know, whether you go down to Pakistan or Sri Lanka or Indonesia or a whole range of other countries. So I think the key is probably to look at, you know, how we can bring this issue to the front and say, look, this is an issue. I think the critical aspect that one needs to look at is road accidents, you know, large in number, a lot of people unnecessarily injured, lives are lost. What could we do to minimize that? I think that's a critical question. And one of the factors that can help would be to have drivers whose vision is adequate. It's safe for them. So at least that way, one variable that can cause an accident, you know, is eliminated. So I think looking at it from that perspective and all the things that we can put in place, like I mentioned before, whether it's, you know, awareness or getting systems in place, a whole range of things, I think, you know, would be beneficial. And like what Kristen has mentioned, it is a big problem. Half the drivers need glasses. Probably 1% of them shouldn't be driving. So, you know, I think the numbers are quite scary.
Kristen, what's your take on this?
You know, I think Vinod is right. It's not an independent issue for India. This is a worldwide problem. As we look at, you know, just the global landscape, you know, you have organizations like the WHO, the World Bank, UN. UN has just named its second decade of road safety. And for the first time ever, ensuring that the population has good vision is actually in the recommendations from the UN. And I think that will assist us as well in the work that we're trying to do for India and for countries around the world. So I think that we have a good opportunity. I think that the volume is being raised on this discussion. Definitely, if we have a percentage that's higher than the global average, we have an opportunity for success to improve this as we go. So thank you.
While concluding the session, I would like to mention that a task force on vision and road safety has been set up with representatives from the Vision Impact Institute, Sight Savers, Essilor India, Mission for Vision, Vision Spring, India Vision Institute, and Optician India. This task force aims to identify barriers in reducing the number of road traffic accidents reported due to poor vision in India and explore ways to address them. The outcomes from these discussions will form part of a presentation to the government for action as appropriate. I would like to thank Vinod, Daniel, and Kristen for joining us today.
Thank you, Madhur. Thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you so much for joining us.